Welcome to the newly updated EWE 2021 edition. Newly updated titles. The world title has changed. We've seen the arena has changed, and we're going to reveal it in a minute. I just want to say I hope you guys stay safe in 2021. Well, we've already been in there for like 21 days, but still. This is our big upgrade. It took a while to do, but we are now proud to present EWE 2021 edition. Here we go. About to reveal the stage. It's been pitch black for a few hours now. And there it is. Why is it saying Backlash? So Adrian, does this place around me look familiar in any way? I don't think you would know what this place looked like, but you know who lived here. And if not, well, that's just a sign that, well, you don't care about anyone, do you? You see, I know who your first match was. I was there in attendance in the TGM show when it would just kick off, and it is its first ever episode and your first ever match in this little company. And I saw your first ever match live in front of my eyes. Adrian versus Abyss. Now, the reason why I ask, do you remember this place? Well, you may not know, because a lot of people didn't know, but Alex Stevens and someone else had a match here. I think it was a stage crew, either way. They had a match here, and this was called Abyss's House, I think. Either way, I knew it was his house. And the reason I knew, you don't even want to know. Let's just say I had a strong relationship with Abyss before, well, Death did what he did. But I don't care about him now. And well, the reason why I bring his dead, rotting corpse up below my feet here is because, well, I wanted you to remember. What do you remember when he's basically the person who gifted you? He's the one who made the team, the creative team, look, say, oh look, this guy is talented. This man gave you so much because of your match. And you didn't even put him over once. You didn't even see him ever again. This man put his heart and soul to try and help people. And that's why he died. Although he didn't seem like it, if he liked you, then he would help you train. Now, unfortunately, because of his unnatural behaviour, apparently, people didn't like that, so they stayed away from him. But after you and Abyss's match, I came up to him to see if he was okay when, well, the lights shut off and everything. And he said, yeah. And we talked nearly every single week on the phone until he told me to come over. So I came over, prepared, obviously, just in case it was an ambush. And, well, he taught me how to wrestle. And ever since I've became who I am today, I look down at this corpse. I look down to the person who taught me everything I know. I look down to him and I see all the hatred slowly dripping away from his body. He never wanted to hurt anyone. You made him hurt people. PJ Styles, my own tag team partner Knight. This is my hangabout now. This is where I go to remember the past memories and train. Anyway, back to you, Adrian. You probably didn't even remember Abyss's face, did you? You probably thought it was just a pushover. No, he let you win that match so you would advance to greater heights, and look where you are now. In my fingertips. And trust me, boy, if you ever want to fight me, I'm not going to put you over. But I will put you 6 feet under. After that, here we are. EWE upgraded stadium for the match. The first match. And talking of changes, here's Charlie, been working on his boxing and his UFC, and he is ready to kick some ass tonight. But here's a person who is probably filled with anger. It's Adrian after, well, his tag team partner Paul has been captured by the hardcore champion, which is Biker. Abyss is dead. And, well, he is obviously quite pissed today, because he will not have to defend, he cannot defend his championship until Paul is, well, freed from Biker's grasp. And as we saw just a minute ago, Biker is willing to go as far, is what he's trying to say, as far as he wants to make Adrian understand what it's like to be in, well, Biker's position. Adrian, you can see here tonight, serious, he's just posing in front of the fire. He has also, I guess, gotten back, like, the little straps, I think they're called, like, little just straps of hair going down his face. He's got that hairstyle back, and he's smiling, but deep inside, anger fills him. See, that smile just died off. These two, just looking at each other. Charlie going back. Now look at this, this is what I mean. The UFC slash boxing MMA skill by Charlie. He's become one of the best submission specialists we have in the main roster locker room. By far. Oh, he missed the kick. And now he's flexing, look. Adrian did not see this one coming. Next up, we'll have a match, to a five-man battle royale to determine who's coming 10th. Who's going to be in 10th place come the showdown rumble match. Who will be placing 10th place, which is a pretty decent spot, but not as good as 20 or 30. No, wait, we're going up to 20, never mind. Not as good as the 20 spot, which will decide next episode. And now Adrian just being thrown into the barricade over and over again, just trying to wrench down at that midsection. Charlie drops him on it. But now, wait a minute, oh, a chopped right to the throat, slowing down all of his possession. And oh God, into the ring. And then now an elbow. And now Adrian, he's getting in the ring, stomps on the arm of Charlie. I don't know if you saw that. And now puts him in a sleeper hold. Charlie should know how to get out of this from all of his training, but he's been popped into a sleeper hold. So that might have came in surprise for him, but he rolls through and throws Adrian over the head. A very angry Adrian as well. Someone you don't want to be in the ring with. Lifts him up. Oh, big kick to the face. And now lifted up again. Oh, another one. No, wait, no, that was knees to the midsection. And Charlie's just sizing up Adrian. Taunting. And now a drop kick right to the midsection. And he looks for a punch. But Adrian, reversal. And now takes the legs and a wrestling takedown. And a kick. And now going for the legs, a big elbow. Stopping any of the high flying abilities. And look at Adrian, out of range, just punching. Out of rage even, just punching Charlie right in the face. And they're stomping him on him. Look at him, relentless. Extreme Rules match, this is allowed. In the corner. Two, three matches confirmed for Showdown on next pay-per-view. It will be the Warlord Hayden versus Inferno for the EWE Legendary Championship. It will be Tyler versus the Tank for the EWE World Championship. What's going on here? That is Bikers Titantron. And Adrian saying, come on, get out of here now. Get him out of here. And Charlie, from behind, takes him down. Into an armbar, and he's turning it around. Trying to break the arm, but he's let go. Biker. In the way, and a Pele kick. Even though I'm pretty sure that's not even his finisher anymore, but one. Two, three, Biker has just cost Adrian the match. And he's not going to be happy about that one. But congratulations to Charlie. As you can see, he's got a cut open right above his eyelid. Probably from all the punches and everything. Anyway, we're going to be seeing who's going to be drawing number 10 in the Showdown Rumble match. This is stupid, but I'm gonna say it anyway, just for anyone who believes that the Warlord Hayden can actually retain his championship at Showdown. I can see it in the future. It's going to be a place where everyone thinks they're going to get their opportunity set for them. Because that's one little match that I can easily win because half the roster here are scums. But they think they're going to win this match. Which, okay, maybe so. But they don't know what's on the other side of the fucking rainbow. So they may be all happy, travelling, trash-talking and stuff, and then they get to Grand. And then they get to Grand, and it all comes crashing down. The smiles fade from their face. The realisation of the two months ago have been wasted. The training, everything is gone. I'm telling you right now, Tank, I don't care if you're doing this for yourself or me. Make that fuck Tyler. Just make him non-existent. I don't want to see his little grubby hands all over my championship. It's mine. I've ruled through so many places and I deserve that championship around my waist. I don't care if he's remaking it or anything. I am having that damn championship. And Tank, I heard what you said. If you're not going to give it to me, I'll take it right off. You want to know something funny? No. I wasn't given an opportunity at the world title. I was given a title opportunity at the Legendary Championship. But why? Oh wait, because the GM knows. The GM knows I will beat Tyler. See Tyler, how does it feel that your own boss, the own man who hired you, doesn't have any faith in you? Because you can see that if he did think that you're going to beat me, he would have given me the shot. not the tank. Sure, Tank requested it, but we all know that I will win it if I was in Tank's place. But anyway, I'm not really that bothered. My time will surely come. And soon at Showdown, I'm going to enter that Rumble. And I'm going to win. And I'm going to turn the story around with a happy ending of me, Wade Inferno, lifting that EWE World Championship from either Tank, Tyler, or whoever comes out of the KO Chamber alive, or whatever bullshit that happens, you bet I'm getting my hands on the title. And now the Wolf. What is there to say about you? You fought White Assassin. What else? Do you really think because you super kicked me, I'm going to go down? No. I have been training years and years of my retirement just so I can join this and take the happiness that you have away from you. At Music Town, I was utterly, well, embarrassed. Me, the golden son of wrestling, the man who has beaten Braun Strowman in the... No. Yes, actually. The man who has powerbombed Braun Strowman, the man who's beaten Shinsuke, the man who's beaten Brock Lesnar, the man who had to claw his way up the mountain in WWE to get what he deserved. And it all got taken away from me. Do you know how that feels? That super kick almost ended my career. And that's not a lie. And to make matters worse, Wolf, you come out and, because you're a heel guy, you hit me with a car. Just because you're jealous. You attacked me with a car. That's what started all of this. You can't say that I started it when you did. Now, because me and Tank won that match, with flying colours by the way, I want to propose the match stipulation. I want it to be a last man... No, actually. I want it to be a Falls Count Anywhere match. That's right. Not a last man standing, but a Falls Count Anywhere match. So, if you've got any balls, come and see me backstage. And maybe talk it through with me. And then, well, get ready for a match, can't we? And just so you know, I'm not taking it easy. I am going to make you suffer. Just like the Tank is going to make Tyler suffer. Yeah, right, bitch. Ugh. Only relevant in this company because you go after the world champion. And I think you know that. You've been nothing. You mean nothing to me since day one. The only reason you got my attention is because you put me for a table and now we're equal. And I accept your challenge. Falls Count Anywhere. I mean, if we're going to talk about attacking you, you're going to do it soon anyway. So, I might as well get the head start, eh? Yeah? Yeah. Face it, Inferno. You're not going to beat me. I'm going to recreate what happened at Music Town. And I'm going to end your career this time for good. So don't think of even coming back. And you're bringing shit up to make you look like the victim. Sure, I was a piece of shit back then, but I've changed now. And you have became the real piece of shit. Just look at yourself. Ordering people around to do your dirty work while you can't even take a single shot. Huh? What does that make you? Oh, I'll tell you, Inferno. I'll tell you for you. A piece of shit, or more appropriately, a piece of garbage. Here we go. The winner of this match will come number 10. We'll draw the number 10 in the showdown rumble match. The winner of this match will get... Oh, shit. The winner of that match, should I say, will get a EWE World Championship opportunity at EWE Grand in the main event. So we've seen the star who will be having a match tonight. We've seen Thunderbolt, who, well, this is his only match tonight. Perhaps he wants to take home the championship for the Bikers. Comes a third man. A man who's soon near to his retirement. At the end of this season, he will... Well, he will retire. It's been confirmed. Alex, this man, an inspiration to a lot of people in the locker room. It's unfortunate that we have to see him go, but... Well, we just hope that he does have a good life from now on. And onwards. Obviously, hardcore games didn't go too well for him. Here's a person who's also faced Tyler before, just like, Wait, no, Alex didn't. Just like Thunderbolt, even. And it's Death. Death has faced Tyler before multiple times. Tyler has stared Death in the eye and still survived. But this is the Death we're talking about, who, well, some may say have come the closest to beat Tyler. And here he comes, Austin. The man from SmackDown Live a while back. Some may say in his prime. He's still looking to make... He's still looking to bust onto the scene in EWE. But, well, it's not going that well for him. He almost had his arm broken last time we saw him in the ring. Let's hope that things get better for him. Here we go, everyone warming up. The five-man battle royale has started. Austin going straight for the star. Death suplex to Alex, and Thunderbolt has no one to fight, but he's looking to eliminate the second person. No, actually, remembering it, Death fucked up Thunderbolt and Thingy's match. If you forget what happened, and Tyler's match, if you forget what happened, Thunderbolt was just moments away from capturing the EWE World Championship, and then Death hacked the signals, the star is out, hacked the signals, and the arena went pitch black. We don't know what happened, and then we just saw Tyler going for the pin, and then the referee saw it, counted it, and it was a free count, and Tyler retained. So if it wasn't for Death, Thunderbolt might, and might up here, like all the way over here, might have still been the EWE World Champion. But the thing is, if you know Tyler, he probably would have kicked out of that anyway. So it's a bit of a debate. Anyway, Alex on Thunderbolt, Austin on Death. Austin looks like he's bringing his all into this match. Well, okay, now he's slowing down. And an uppercut, Alex and Austin. These two, I definitely future Hall of Famers. Austin's still got quite a lot of ahead of him. Quite a lot of wrestling years ahead of him still. But Alex, well, like I said, he's retiring at the end of this season, and we hope to, well, still stay in touch with him, I guess, see what he wants. Maybe he can be a general manager of EWE. Anyway, Death striking off, and we saw a roundhouse to Thunderbolt. That must hurt. Let's just go over all the specialties here. Alex, well, all around great. Austin, amazing high flyer. High flying is like his specialty. Death, just a brute. And Thunderbolt, the master of wrestling, basically. When he gets you where he wants you, he can do some insane damage. and Austin was just being choked out there. A big punch right to the eye. Oh yeah, also Star, well, I guess it's kind of good for the Star that he got eliminated first. Star will be up against the Tank right after this match, actually. So, I mean, that's kind of awesome to be for him, I guess. Anyway, Austin looking to eliminate Alex. Maybe looking to make his, make some of his achievements he still wants to do in EWE short, but Alex trying to make his dreams live on. I guess he really wants to win this Rumble, I guess, so does Austin. If it's going to come down to it, I think it's going to come down to these two, either in the Rumble or in this match here. And now Thunderbolt looking to throw Death over, maybe some sweet old-fashioned revenge for maybe a year ago now. No, it can't be a year ago, maybe like 5 or 6 months of, well, just possible EWE World Champion time. Although Tyler most likely would have kicked out of it anyway. Anyway, oh, a face breaker to Austin. An uppercut. Thunderbolt is on the ropes. The Death is going to just strike away. Now he's going to try and throw him over. And now, oh no, Austin's holding on to the top rope. Austin's out. And Thunderbolt might be on his way out here by Death. Alex trying to make his dreams a reality and Thunderbolt is still in. And oh god, a urine marquee to Thunderbolt. And Alex having none of it. Trying to throw Death out. Got down, leapfrog into something, but doesn't look like it was queued right. And now Death just drops Alex on his back. And now puts Thunderbolt in the turnbuckle, a strike. And again, and another one. And now stomping down. Wait a minute, a dragon suplex to Death. And now a kick, Alex not fazed about the sudden emergement from Death, just getting straight back up. And now Alex, no way, explode a suplex to the outside. It's Thunderbolt and Alex. These are the only two who remain. Which one is going to be 10th in the Showdown Rumble match? And a big knee across the jaw. What is this? Thunderbolt's got him right where he wanted him. This could be a great normal match, to be fair. I would pay to see these two fight. Oh no, Thunderbolt. Thunderbolt looking to eliminate Alex. He obviously either wants his revenge or he wants the title for the Biker Gang, and Thunderbolt has placed himself in 10th place for the Showdown Rumble. Let's look at some of these replays. That face breaker. Okay. Bang, turns him inside out in a kind of alternative one that you need move. And now look, Thunderbolt just picks him up and chucks him over the rope, and Thunderbolt will be placing 10th in the match, in the Showdown Rumble match. And that is a very good space. That is like halfway. That is half the competitors just dealt with immediately. Thunderbolt obviously very happy with that win. We have one more match and it will be the Tank versus the Star. And here we go, the Tank coming out in his original green Tyler! The EWE World Champion. Oh, I think he wants a revenge. The Tank looks back. Oh god! The Tank looked back and all he saw was Tyler, face full of rage, after him. Tyler definitely can't believe that he's got another shot at the World Championship. And now Tank is just mowing him apart with chops and everything. Tyler feeling his chest, being pushed up the ramp. Oh my god! What the hell? The Tank just throwing him! Oh god. Onto the stage now. And now another strike. And I've taken him. And flattens him on the new stage. The match has been cancelled because of Tyler coming out to attack the tank. So, I mean, I guess I'll say goodbye for now. Oh, look at these chops. Similar to the star. Mowing Tyler down. Tyler planned a sneak attack, but it didn't really go well, did it? Another chop. Punch. And now, oh God, gonna do that thing again where he slams his head onto the stairs. What happened to my voice then? Oh no. Oh no, powerbomb. Powerbomb position. And oh God, sideways. Just carrying him. No, 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 onto the light. And now taking the arms again. So it's just the same moves over and over again, but they still look really effective. And now Tyler kips up. He ain't taking any of the bull crap. Strikes. And again, knees. And not, no, he's going to try and lift him up. For a suplex on the stage. Holy shit. How has he got the willpower to do that? The referee saying, that's enough, that's enough, that's enough. And backing Tyler up. How the hell has he done that? Thank you guys for watching EWE. The EWE, first ever EWE upgraded 2021 episode.